The Zoom G6 multi-effects processor. It's the latest addition to their multi-effects lineup. The G11, of course, is the big flagship. This guy kind of sits somewhere in between, and it's very clever, I think, because it's got these four different modes that you can use to select different displays or functionality within each preset. 240 presets are available on tap. You can write over the factory ones or include your own. You can pop your own IRs or impulse responses into it as well. There are about 22 different amplifier models, 22 matching cabinet models in here, a huge slew of effects. You can have 9 different effects in any order pretty much, or 7 effects with an amp and a cab sim. There's a looper on board as well, 45 seconds of looping. If you use an SD card, which you can pop in here, you can have up to 2 hours of looping. But the other cool thing, of course, is this touch screen, which allows me to manipulate and do anything and create anything pretty much that I want within the board itself. So I've just written this little preset called BK High Watt, which is based on their High Watt model with a High Watt cabinet. I've got a noise gate in front there that's not even turned on at the moment, and a vibe here, and what's called the squeak, which is the rat pedal, a tape echo, and a hall delay. Now, as you can see down here, I'm on effect board mode. If I go to bank patch mode here, it will let me go up and down the banks and 4 patches within each bank. So if I go down a bank, it's empty at the moment. But if I go back to bank double A, we can go here. If I go to memory, it will give me the name of the bank, and then I've got immediate access to the 4 presets within that bank. So for instance, BK High Watt, which is what you heard at the front, Ambivox. BK Rock. And BK Float, which is like an ambient kind of thing. So if I want to edit that, all I've got to do is go back to effect board and I can either switch on or off those effects. For instance, the reverb in that one. And the tremolo. I can turn the phaser on or off. And or the distortion. Pretty simple. Makes accessibility and on-stage use very easy. With the touchscreen, I've then got 4 pages of these icons with which to manipulate everything. So, for instance, if I want to change the effect order, I can just hit this icon here, and that lets me either, you know, just drag these guys, maybe put the reverb before the delay, for instance, or put the phaser before the red crunch, and then I can hit back again and flip it up, and there you go. It's all happening. Now you can see that these have little arrows pointing to these switches. If I just tap on them, they will disengage those assignments, and then I can assign them again if I want. For instance, if I want to assign the phaser to this first switch, all I've got to do is touch it like so. If I want to assign the red crunch, which is kind of a crunch box thing, to effect 2, there I go. If I want the ping pong delay over here on effect 3, and because I've got 4, you see, and then if I want space hole, it'll reassign them, put the ping pong here and the reverb there. Beautiful. You've got an input, You've got a mono effects loop, which you can pop anywhere in the signal path as well. You've got stereo outputs, and that's what you're hearing today. I'm running direct to a Presonus Quantum and into Logic, so you can hear it in all of its hi-fi glory. And then you've got USB, because there's a Guitar Lab application as well, which you can use on your computer to edit and get right into deep editing and manipulation of all of these different models and things. So let's have a listen to some more sounds. That's what you want to hear, I'm sure. So I'm going to go down all the way down to bank A, and I'll speed up the video. So that's called Solo Velvet. It's using their Velvet amplifier. There's an IR in there. And again, you can import your own IRs if you wish. Tape Echo, Bright Hall. There's a noise gate up the front and a Tube Screamer drive. So if I go to Bank Patch Memory again, we can flick through each of these. Cram Rock, let's have a listen to that. Nice, double Pollux. Clean Loom. Delay. There's a tap tempo up here, so you can tap in your BPMs. Excellent. Of course, there are rhythm tracks as well if you want to play along with the drum. Could do that all day. 68 different rhythms. So there you go. You've got 22 amps, 22 cabs. You can load up to 70 different impulse responses in there. There's a whole heap of different effects. Four different modes with which to use these 6-foot switches with, even some pedal specific effects, stereo out, mono in, mono effects loop, easy to carry, it's built well, it's got this carbon graphite kind of shell thing happening, and it sounds great. The Zoom G6.